Hello and welcome to this, my second vlog on sailboat maintenance. Today we're going to be tackling the toilet, the head, and we're going to be talking and looking about replacing a joker valve on a Jabsco manual toilet. I've already had a go at this job, and all I could get locally was a TMC joker valve, and my little bit of online research implied that this valve was an equal replacement for the Jabsco version. This is the TMC, and this is the Jabsco. And the first impressions, they look totally interchangeable. I suspect that they are, I know they're not interchangeable. The Jabsco valve, this one, its flange here is thicker than the TMC version. If I put them side by side or close to side by side, you can see that probably a third again thicker with the Jabsco. What that means is when you're bolting it up against the toilet, the thickness here doesn't allow for a good seat and you get a leak if you use the TMC joker valve. So I suspect they're interchangeable the other way around, though. I suspect that a Jabsco valve with a thicker flange will fit where the TMC, in a TMC toilet, where a thinner flange is okay, but a thicker flange is probably equally as okay. It's just the other way around. I suspect that that's probably a good view you can see there. If I tip on right, that the Jabsco one is a magnitude thicker in this section here. So I replaced this joker valve on my head about 6 months ago, and it now needs replacing again. What's happening is the valve that's there now is allowing water to pass back up through the valve in the reverse direction, and that's filling the bowl with salt water from outside the boat. Not a huge problem, because I can control that by closing the seacock, but the permanent solution is to replace this valve. So as I say, it's only about 6 months ago I replaced it, which is a lot less than you'd think. And the reason I think this needs replacing is I've used harsh chemicals on the toilet, particularly the thick bleach, and I think that's damaged the neoprene rubber, and it's now allowing this back feed of fluid. Anyway, let's go and have a look at the toilet now and see the job in hand. So this is my Jabsco manual head, probably from around the late 80s. Perfectly serviceable, working just fine. It's probably been serviced a number of times, of course, a number of new valves, and indeed we're going to replace this valve today. So around the outside of it, I've got my underneath. There are two cocks, one which is the through valve for the fresh water for the pumping out. For the feed, and one which allows the effluent to go overside for when I'm out at sea. And behind the toilet is another valve which I can open, and that means I can pump from the bowl into a holding tank. So great, but all requires this valve to be serviceable and operational, and the minute it's not, so we're going to replace it. So let's have a little look closer at where the valve actually sits, and the job that I've got to do to replace it. So here's the back of my toilet, and the valve sits within this section of pipe here, within this elbow. Now normally I think what you need to do is just purely release this elbow, pull it back, pull out the old joker valve and replace it with a new. So it sits in here,
you can't see if it's in here, thus. In this case, because I've got a very tight hole in the back here, I can't actually pull this valve back. So what I have to do is take the whole pump assembly off of the base of the toilet, which then allows me to fish this valve out and replace it. So both of my seacocks are closed, really important of course, because otherwise we're going to fill the boat with water very quickly. And all we need for this job is a screwdriver. Okay, so for me, I'm going to have to undo this screw here and its screw opposite, and allow this pipe, the exhaust pipe, exit pipe, off of the back of the pump, and also lift the pump off of the base. I'm sure that that means that I'm going to have to replace the seals on the pump more quickly than if I could pull this pipe back and leave the pump assembly in place. But that's the way we're going to have to do it on this boat. Your boat may be different, and you might find it easier to replace. So, without further ado, let's get some rags down here to catch any water that will be in there, because there will be some in, and replace this valve. So, let's get on and replace this. It's quite easy, as I said, just undo these. I've got six screws to undo, drop the new valve in, get on with it. Okay, so I've replaced the valve in the toilet now, and that's working fine. This is the old valve that's come out, and just so you can see, if you can, if I can position this right, you can see the valve is gaping open here, and I think that's down to the chemical attack from the thick bleach that I put down the toilet once. I don't know whether you can see when you look from this end, if I can position it right, there you go, you can see light underneath the and through the valve. So anyway, really easy job, probably took about 5 minutes in total. Not a lot of waste come out of the pipework. That might be a reflection of my pipework, your boat might be different, but a really simple job, and a job that everybody that owns a toilet on a boat should know how to do. Anyway, there we go. So we'll watch this for the next 12 months and see whether this next valve lasts longer if I look after it a bit better and don't abuse it with such harsh chemicals. Just going to use vinegar to try and eliminate any calcium buildup that can happen in this valve as well. Anyway, thank you for watching, and catch you again soon.